Hello, my name is Dr. James Shamia. I'm a pulmonary and critical care physician and also Senior Vice President and Chief Operating Officer at the University of Tennessee Medical Center. This is now the fourth week that I've spent a few minutes with you to update you about the COVID-19 situation, and it continues to worsen. The main point today is that the situation is accelerating and we are becoming increasingly concerned. You've probably heard that over the past week, the state of Tennessee has broken its prior hospitalization record with more patients in the ICU than during the winter surge. I'm going to go through some local data over the next few minutes, and then I'll tell you what I think this means for our local community. So this shows the number of new cases week over week across all of these counties. So you see over on the right-hand side, the number of new cases continues to rise. It may look like that's starting to level off, but it's important to note that we're actually doing about 50% of the amount of testing we were doing during the winter peak. The positivity rate, which is another indicator of how much COVID is circulating in the community, is now greater than 20%. So our sense is that the cases are continuing to rise. This shows the number of patients in the hospital with COVID-19 each day across all the hospitals in all of these counties. What you see on the right-hand side with this most recent data is that total number is 592 patients. But I think more notable is you see how steep that line is on the right. It is showing no indication of plateauing at this point. Now, this shows information from our hospital. So first of all, we have 155 patients with COVID-19 in the hospital. That's an increase in 23 patients over the last 7 days and 114 patients over the last 30 days. When you look at this slide and the one before, it just drives home the point that this is a community-wide issue that is affecting all hospitals in the region. In the lower left, we see the percentage of fully vaccinated and not fully vaccinated. 87% of patients in the hospital are not fully vaccinated. And then in the intensive care unit, as of this morning, 95% of the patients in the intensive care unit were not fully vaccinated. Then on the right-hand side, lower right, you see the ages, and you see that the average age in the intensive care unit is only 56 years old. This is, again, data from our hospital, and it drives home an important point. Over on the right-hand side, you see the current surge, currently at 155 patients. Our prior peak was on December 30th with 140 patients. But I think what is most notable to us is the rate of rise. You see in the box, the average growth per day back in the winter of 2020 was just over a patient a day, whereas now our average growth is between 2.5 to 3 patients a day. So we are rising at a rate about 2.5 times higher than we were in the prior surge in the winter, and there's no indication at this point that is slowing down. So to summarize, our hospital and the other hospitals in the region are either at or have exceeded their prior peak of COVID-19 patients in the hospital. At our hospital, 27% of our beds, including ICU beds, that are appropriate for medical and surgical patients, currently house patients with COVID-19. The vast majority of those patients are in the hospital because of COVID-19, and they're quite sick. We had previously looked at data that had suggested that this would peak and plateau around the second week of September, but when you see the rate of rise of hospitalizations of what I showed you, we're becoming less confident that that is the case. And at this point, to be quite frank, we really don't know how high that number is going to go. Many of you have heard that we requested and received assistance from the National Guard. We're very thankful for that. We're going to be resubmitting our application to hopefully retain those folks and even ask for more assistance. We've opened 2 surge areas, and that's been very challenging because of staffing, because we have to realize that COVID-19 has hit all hospitals and all of healthcare at the same time. So trying to get extra staff to open up surge areas is very challenging right now. I think there is this general sense that in this type of situation, healthcare will just figure it out. And while we're very good at doing this, and we try as hard as we can, we came to the realization this week that there probably is a ceiling to what we can do in terms of what we're able to staff. So healthcare is truly not an infinite resource at this point. I think it's important to emphasize the interconnectedness in all of healthcare, meaning not just hospitals are feeling this strain. The same strain is in home health, in post-acute care, in outpatient practices, and even in the EMS and emergency medical services. So in a perfect situation, when one area is feeling the strain, other areas can help bail them out. But what we're seeing now is the whole system is strained, and that definitely impacts our ability to get patients through the hospital. What I also think we're seeing is that same interconnectedness exists in society. And what I mean by that is we see a lot of individuals and organizations making decisions based on their individual priorities and values. And I'm not saying that that's right or wrong in any way. We all want this behind us and we all want to get back to our normal lives. But what I am saying is that the landing place all of those independent decisions and where they all collide is in the healthcare delivery system. That's an inescapable fact. And that ultimately affects patients both who have COVID-19 and other patients as well. So one thing I encourage you to do, and it's posted on our Facebook page, is all the health systems together had a joint statement yesterday summarizing the situation. I recommend and urge you to read that. And then I want to close today's video the way I close every video, which is to reinforce those things you can do to help protect yourself and your family. So first of all, get vaccinated. But I need to emphasize that we've definitely seen cases in the hospital where somebody was vaccinated 5 or 7 days ago, has COVID, and now has been admitted to the hospital and maybe in the intensive care unit. And so it's still so important to follow the other core actions. Keep your distance and stay at home when sick. Wear face coverings. Wash your hands regularly and clean frequently touched surfaces. So again, I thank you for your attention, and I plan to be with you next week to give you another update.